Welcome back, Tube Dwellers, to more of the Mad Bags Skyrim. We are going to continue touching the sky. I've filled the Ewer at the first wayshrine. I have four left. We're right back in the Forgotten Vale, the cave I had just entered, or I should say the section of cave that I had just entered upon shutting down for the last episode. Oh my. And we have some height already in the cave. Little suspicious looking platform. Did Serana just... Yeah, she did. Luckily she can't die. Unkillable as she is, she can fall all she'd like. And apparently I have left the cave system. Wow. That is pretty crazy looking. These weird veil deer. I don't think anything down here is hostile unless I run into another saber cat. I suppose they do lurk. I may not be able to spot them from a distance. It's a little bit eerie. It's really quiet. There's a lot of fog. I cannot quite see all the way across this veil. I have quite a few different objective points. Oh, there one of those Veil Saber Cats is. Yeah, we taught him. We are animal trainers. Coming here to teach all y'all Veil Cats. They can't do this stuff. They can't just attack. Random wanderers? What was that? Oh my, multiple spiders. They look ugly too. They look like a real cold blue. I think I'll just, I'll stand on my medieval equivalent of a chair. I am the sissy girl afraid of spiders. Luckily I don't have the same thing with skeevers. Filthy skeever. Alright, well, I guess I'm just gonna strike out. Let me take a peek at my map. So, I've got the four, objectives for the other four instances of filling the ewer, and I assume this area is cut off just because there's a lot of fog between this area and the actual mainland. I suppose it's possible that I could actually leave the area that I'm supposed to be in and go back to the mainland, but I don't think that's incredibly likely. I think it's much more likely that each of these paths that goes off to the side of this all go to a different way shrine and a different ewer, and I think by chance I may no, I can't really tell which way I'm pointing. Let's see, that's south. For a second I was thinking it looked like I was heading towards the furthest one away. I never saw anything like this back on the island. Go figure that I would go straight towards the hardest one to get to, the furthest one away, but I'm not sure that that's the case. An unknown book, volume 1. Bring ancient farmer tome to Urag Groshub. Interesting, so I've gotten a side quest, I believe. That has to do with probably learning more about the farmer. That's interesting. I wonder how long that book is. Maybe I'll read it real quick. Haha, fat chance on reading all of that mess. So obviously that'll have to be translated. Okay, that is fine. I'm sure Urag can help me with that. I am a mage of quite some standing, so Urag should be happy to help. I'm actually his boss. So let's see here. If I go straight south, it's going to be one of these kind of close ewers. As a matter of fact, I think I see it right there in the distance with a little bit of a sword. Oh, I got robbed out of part of that shout. I must have sunk into the water, which is strange because that whirlwind sprint shout is supposed to just carry you straight at equal altitude directly in the direction that you're facing. Yeah, I think it is too. I suppose I could sprint. It's daytime. I won't get my stamina back. But did I pass it? I feel... Yeah, I did. My objective's right up here. I believe I can get to it. A couple of different sides. Yes. Hello, priest who is definitely not just a spirit.
Shrine of learning, initiate.
Learning.
Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Arei-El and fill your vessel with his enlightenment?
Yes, prelate.
Are you prepared
Celegrate.
To honor the mantras of Arei-El and fill your vessel with his enlightenment?
I said, yes, prelate. Celegrate.
Arei-El bless you, child. For you are a step closer to the inner sanctum and everlasting wisdom.
Inner sanctum. That sounds very much so like a place that I'm gonna end up. Come on, wayshrine. What? Ah! Okay. Whew! I really cannot see the blue on that. That's her pet. But I can't tell. Draw water basin. Boom, the ewer is filled. So what is this? The portal to Darkfall Passage. Okay, so that's kind of neat. It looks like each one of these wayshrines will head back to... I guess that first wayshrine I saw was the, the parent wayshrine. The original wayshrine that acts as a hub for all the others, it seems safe to assume. And I would fare to bet that somewhere up there is another wayshrine. It looks like... the left side of this hill over here may be the way to go to get up there. This could be, a matter of fact, I kind of see the path. This could be a bit of a long trek, and there's not a whole lot interesting looking. I may dive in the water a little bit, and if I find anything, I'll definitely let you know about it. Oh my. So I probably didn't catch the best angle of that, but I just fell off a waterfall while swimming around in the lake. Jesus, it's still carrying me. Yeah, chill. Serana, I'm working on it.
Next time I say to please not go over the waterfall, maybe you'll listen to me.
Yeah, and maybe I won't. I wonder if I'm going to end up going towards the faraway wayshrine now. That is quite the waterfall. Kind of crept up on me. I didn't really notice that I was going, oh boy, we have already hatched Charis and Farmer with them. Oh man, they are all around me. My shield is not on. Oh, I'm gonna take a hit. I still did not. I don't know how I dodged that. Okay, the Charis is down. We have Farmer still. A feral Farmer, nonetheless. Ew. These are basically ghouls. As if the Farmer themselves aren't. No, the Farmers are ghouls too. Apparently the Farmer are slightly more intelligent ghouls than their feral brethren. I'm seeing not much. Dead Charis. A lot of them, too. I wonder if they're, like, harvesting more mosquito-like Charis hunters. Looks like I could continue my journey there. I feel like I may be missing something here, though. Let me look around a little bit more. Regular Farmer dead before I even arrive. Huh. So the feral Farmer are killing the regular Farmer. Huh. Not sure what that means. I'm not sure if it's good or bad. More dead Farmer. More chests. Ah, we're back to the Farmer that liked to use chests. Those others did not. Certainly did not. We've got a thing about storing our goods. We'd rather just carry it. All of it. Creepy blue mist. Apparently no purpose. I guess the creepy blue mist is all around these mushrooms. Not necessarily around that little crevasse. And okay, more loot. And I think that is probably about all on this side. Let me see if I can cross the river without falling in again. Yes, of course I can. Now, is there anything on this side before I continue further down? I guess that's an easy way around. Didn't have to get all risky and try to shout my way across. I can make a pretty avid use of my sprint now, because while I'm underground, I don't know whether it's sunny out or not. The sunlight, either way, doesn't affect me the same. And I can just... continuously sprint, regenerate my stamina. I'm gonna try to whirlwind sprint, I think from the highest point I can find over here, and see if I can at least hit this edge. Maybe this edge. This edge looks a little bit lower. No, it does not work. Let me try one more place, just because I wanna be a exploration Nazi. And the verdict is... No. I am not having the easiest of times. Suppose I could just jump a little bit and look up there. I don't really see anything. I don't think I can even pick those mushrooms, so let me stop obsessing. And just go over the next waterfall. It feels like I am racing, oh boy, really fast into the unknown. Yes, I certainly am. This may be, I feel like I have two different ways I could go here, and I have no choice in the matter. I'm going to continue down, holy crap. Am I where I think I am? Something tells me I just got set back a long, long ways. Alright, hold on here. Hold on, I just want to see. Sure enough, I'm back in the bottom of Darkfall Passage. Oh man, I've got some walking to do. I guess that wasn't horrible. So, right down there is the pool of water that I just came out of. So I basically just had to ascend to the top of this room, this one chamber. And it takes me back to a wayshrine, the first one. And this goes right back to the Forgotten Vale. Now I do find myself, well, once again at the beginning of the Forgotten Vale, so I do have to walk back through what little bit of Vale there is here. And I'm betting it's daylight out still, so my stamina is probably going to be staying low. Oh, don't want to fall through that. Alright, well, let's see. I went south, I got the one-way shrine, meaning that I now have a total of two. I suppose north and, let's see, northeast and then northwest are my next two, and then I'm going to try to make the trek out to that one. This one looks a lot closer, so let's go to it first. Just to make this less painful, I'm going to go ahead and wait till nighttime. I believe 10 p.m. counts as nighttime. Looks like my stamina... Holy mongrel! I always say mongrel, I don't know why. I think the original saying is holy mackerel. Mackerel's a type of fish. I assume that the saying originated when somebody caught a big fish. Yeah, now that it is nighttime though, I can sprint. That is nice, that'll allow me to traverse a farmer. Oh, and I just get hit with an arrow the second I realize. And here's a cave. I wonder what cave this is. The Forgotten Vale Cave. That does not look like it's one of my objectives. Maybe it is. Alright, well let's step inside and see. What do we have on the Forgotten Vale Cave? A pin for some Charis Hunter. A couple Charis too, apparently, at least one. That is actually one of the more powerful. That's not a fledgling, that's an outright hunter. So I just want to see. Yeah, they are noticeably more powerful. They're noticeably bigger, too. But was a lot bigger. At least the Charis go down easy. The flying variations, not so much. I will take that antenna, thank you very much. Ooh, oh, oh. Oh, that was a close one. I just about got ambushed. Forgotten Vale Cave. Of course it's going to be full of some sort of disgusting new insect, and some versions of that insect that are extra nasty. I wonder if there'll be like a giant Charis in some cave down here guarding some way shrine. Some Charis mama that the farmer have yet to turn into a home. Go down, hunter. Okay, is that it? I think there's still one. No, they've finished. We've all wrapped up now. Let me continue killing these eggs. There's a hunter back behind me I could get an antenna off. And, I'm not sure I can jump up to the upper platform in this room. I wonder, though, if I can do something off of this. This looks peculiar. Why is this here? I don't see anything. Yeah, there's something over there. There's something I'm not getting to from this side. I wonder if I could use bats. Just like appear over there. I haven't had much luck using Whirlwind Sprint to cross distances in the air. Let me try it. This should be interesting. This will be my first, like, actual attempt at using bats to some effect. I don't think I've even used it in combat. Let me slide right up here on the very end. And let me try going over there. Hey, look at that! Bats'll do it! Now, did that actually accomplish anything? Probably not. This is probably just, here, go ahead and land for just a second. Huh. So, there was another big charis egg up here. Oh, is there a path right there? Am I really that blind? I guess I wasn't using candlelight. That's my own fault. Let me check real quick in the local. This looks like a door right here, actually. But I don't think I can actually do anything to open it. I think it'll probably just be something later. I actually can't open my map when I'm a vampire. When I'm a vampire lord, that is. How strange. Yeah, there's definitely something over there. I can't get to it, though. Yeah, and you can just walk up right there. Oh, I made a big deal out of that for nothing. So, let's see. Is that the end, then? There's no way. There's no way that that's all that's here. There's got to be a switch. All right, hold on. Aha! I guess being in a vampire helped me not see it. But right up on this platform that I was standing on, there's a little pull rope. A rope release, it says. Activate it. Aha! There, the door slides open. Okay, so now I can stop being a twit. Move deeper. Apparently that would close the door. Oh my god. Oh, that looks gross. I don't know what's going on here. I feel like I'm about to fight a gigantic flying charis bug. Let me see if I can wipe out all these other bugs first. I don't know why I'm going straight towards it. I don't know why I'm not quick saving. Okay, there's a quick save. That seems like a really bad place to be quick saved. What in the world is this thing? And that sound. God, that's weird. If I had a knife, I'll tell you where I'd stick it. Alright, well, I guess it's time to get down here. Let me get both summons going. And nothing at all is gonna happen. Mine a shell bug? What? What does that mean? I need a pickaxe to mine this shell bug. Okay, priority one, find a pickaxe. What in the world? There's gotta be a pickaxe around here, right? There's no way they would do this to me. They wouldn't just have something like this sitting in some chamber and not have a pickaxe close by, right? I don't know why. I refuse to use candlelight. I guess just going into that menu bothers me. I so wish I could just have a hotkey, like a flashlight hotkey. I could just smack and my candlelight would go up. I didn't have to put it on a hand and do all this. Not so fun shenaniganery. Oh, okay, yeah, I blew that one up. Wow, okay, let me look around for a pick a little bit. Ah, well, I made it all the way out of the cave before finding a pick, which is quite annoying, but that's okay. Now I have a pick. I'm gonna run right back down in there and check out this shellfish bug. There's no way. Yeah, I'm overweight. Okay, so I'm gonna have to drop some stuff too. I'll see you when I get back down to the shellfish bug. What? Oh, what a good note. You can I know you. Fast travel. Yeah, I was with the companions. That's where you know me from. It's not because I'm a very hungry-looking vampire, a starving vampire. You can fast travel to and from the Vale, but it is way over out of the way. Okay, so when I originally came over there, they had my view cocked all to the side like this, so I didn't really notice it. But your normal view on Skyrim is, and I think it even needs to crane a little bit more. It needs to crane a little this way. So this is like your default angle on Skyrim, and if you come up here to the top left corner, the Vale just like barely slides by. You can just barely see it. But if you tilt your view out, there you can see it, and you can fast travel to and from it. Oh, how handy. Huh, I just noticed as I run around Whiterun here, time-wise it's still daytime. It's like 5 p.m. But there's a really thick thundercloud out. It's thundering, there's rain, and as you notice in the bottom right, my stamina's regenerating.
You know.
Meaning that apparently stamina regenerates in thunderstorms, whenever you're just not in direct sunlight. That is quite cool. I wonder if it even works in like just shade, like if I find shade behind a mountain or something of the sun, from the sun. I wonder if it would work then. Kind of makes me think so. It's like stealing candy from a baby. Haha, 110 is a much better weight. Alright, back in the Vale once again, taking me back to the beginning. Boy, they could have made the fast travel point a bit more central. There is a fast travel point though, so I guess I won't complain too much. They don't just totally strand you out here in the middle of nowhere. Let's return to this cave and to this shell bug. Oh, looks like I am all too eager to mine. Die, Saber! So the farmer had this guy hidden for some reason. Let's not attack, can we? There it goes. You can normally mine veins by attacking them, and you actually mine a little bit faster than watching this animation, but I'm kind of worried that it might register this guy as a living creature, so it might register my attacks and not mining. I'm getting a... Oh, that sounded gross. Oof. I was mining the backside of him? Is he dead? He's not moving anymore. He's not making any sounds. I think he died. There's a weird light coming from his shell. Alright, well, I noticed mostly gems coming out of him. Was there something else? Shell bug chitin. I bet I can do something with that. I don't know, though. I may have to wait as long as getting Creasy down here and mining it with him. He's my smith. This character doesn't really have many of the smithing perks. Alright, well, let's continue on our quest to the wayshrines. With as lengthy as this has gotten, including all of this cave, I'm thinking, wow, that really looks wicked. I'm thinking I might only be able to include one more wayshrine in this video, and I might have to do the last two by themselves in the next part. So I should be really close to this wayshrine, though. It should be, like, right up this hill. Right as soon as I cross over. At some point, I will cross over, right? Yeah. Yeah! There the wayshrine is! I don't know why I'm preparing for a battle. I guess I was ambushed by a spider last time I came up to one of these wayshrines.
Welcome.
Prelate Arthuring.
This is the wayshrine of sight.
Yes! I see that.
Are you prepared to honor the mountains of Arei-El and fill your vessel with his enlightenment?
I am indeed.
Then behold Ariel's gift, my child. May it speed your journey to the inner sanctum.
Sight.
This must be that beautiful Prelate Arthuring I've always heard about.
Is going to endow me with. That's a shrine up there, isn't it? I wonder. Oh, come on. I'm still on top of the way shrine. I think I can. That's not a shrine. I can't use it to get the blessing. Boo! That should totally be a shrine. For little spazoids like me. Jumping up on the top of it. Whoa, what is this? The other way shrines? Oh, no way! That is too cool! So eventually, as I fill my ewer at each different way shrine, a portal will open up between all of them. Haha! I like it! It's just too bad that these aren't like spaced around like the four or five corners of Skyrim. That would be really cool. Alright, well that makes for another ewer filling. And I could probably squeeze like this other close one in. But I think I'm going to go ahead and make the cutting point here. I think this is a good one. I think both of the other two ewers and then wrapping up the end of this quest might be a good video to follow. So this is going to be what, a three-part touching the sky? Anyway, thanks for watching. Come back for more.